Now, an independent and a group of former Conservative councillors have demanded that Cheryl Gillan attends a public meeting in Great Missenden to explain her position on High Speed 2. The group feels that the Chesham and Amersham MP has not come out staunchly enough since the go-ahead was given on the £33 billion London to Birmingham route, which will cut through the Chilterns in Buckinghamshire. Their anger comes nearly 2 years after Mrs. Gillan was cheered for opposing Labour's HS2 at a public meeting at the Misbourne School. Well, Justin Dealey has more on this story for this morning and joins us on Breakfast. Justin, morning to you. What have people actually been saying in Cheryl Gillan's constituency?
Well, it's an interesting story, this one, Lorna. As you mentioned there, she was certainly cheered for opposing HS2. And last year, of course, she said that she would step down if HS2 was given the go-ahead. So what I did, I went to Amersham just after the decision on January the 10th, and I was talking to people there. And I asked them, should Cheryl Gillan step down?
I think that she should keep to her word if she said that she'll step down.
I mean, has it got to the point now where if she's saying one thing, yet she's doing another, that you haven't got any trust at all in your local MP?
Yes, definitely. You know, they don't say one thing and do the other.
No, I don't think she necessarily should. Well, I think she probably, you know, the whole concept of HS2 needs to be looked at very carefully. All right, she made a statement some time ago, but I think she's within her rights to reconsider that.
Well, I think she's going to retire after this in the next election anyway, so she's not bothered, really, because she's not going to have to put herself up for re-election. But I think many MPs are going to have to consider they're going to be single-issue candidates put up all the way along the line, and that's going to put pressure on them if they want to stand at the next election. So, but no, I'm not surprised, you know. She's just going along with the party line.
Yeah, I think she should stand down if she said she would, and it goes through. Unless, perhaps like me, she can say, well, it's not really harming the Chilterns.
I believe, yes, she will eventually step down, but it very much depends on the route, because the route still is not really defined as such. And, you know, is it a tunnel or is it a cutting with a concrete lid and things like that? So she's a good local MP, but she's caught up in something here which, you know, there are hidden agendas. I'm sure it's something to do with the EU as well, but, you know, that will come out later.
Certainly mixed views, I think it's fair to say. So that's what people in Amersham had to say. And after many days of trying, Cheryl Gillan eventually agreed to speak to me. So we asked her, would she stick to her word and stand down?
No, I'm not going to resign because the government has listened to what I've said and has made changes that I think are good. And why would I? You can only resign once. Why would I resign when government is listening and when government is listening to what is best for my constituents, given the situation that they've made a decision to go ahead? What I did say was that I would resign the whip and would not vote for a bill that did not have substantial changes to it and did not meet the requirements. There is no bill at the moment. We haven't had to vote for it. And I have had some of my requests acceded to.
So that's a big no, then. She won't be stepping down. But clearly there does seem to be an issue over trust. You heard there in the first piece that lady who said that she can no longer trust her local MP anymore. Well, this is how Cheryl Gillan reacts to that.
People and their trust, they must make up their mind whether they trust me or not. But I have always tried my best in 20 years for Chesham and Amersham. I take no vote for granted and I understand and I feel the deepest sympathy for people whose lives are affected by these proposals. Make no mistake, I don't sit here as some hard-hearted harpy thinking that it's happening to someone else. For me, this community is really important, and there are some heartbreaking stories that go along with these proposals, but I am going to continue to build on those concessions that we have already achieved and which I'm really pleased about, to ensure that we get the best possible deal.
Some interesting audio this morning, Justin, from Cheryl Gillan there. But we also understand that the campaigners against HS2 are to seek a judicial review of the government's decision to approve the scheme.
Absolutely. Excuse the pun here, but certainly lots of twists and turns in this story, and there will be, of course, for the next few years. The campaign group Stop HS2, they said they were seeking evidence that the decision was flawed. John Rukin, who is from Stop HS2, he said it had until April to lodge the challenge. An estimated cost that you have mentioned this morning are going to be around £100,000. He's going to be on the programme a bit later on. There will definitely be a judicial review. It just depends who leads it and when that will be, says Rukin. He'll be live on Breakfast after 7 o'clock.
Justin, many thanks for updating us this morning. Yes, we will be speaking to Joe Rukin from Stop HS2 here on Breakfast, as Justin said.
5 minutes past seven on a Thursday morning across Beds, Hearts and Bucks. Simon and Lorna at Breakfast. We're talking this morning about High Speed 2, particularly almost the next stage. There were campaigns against it, lots of them in this area, partly because there was very strong public opinion because of the route through the Chilterns in Buckinghamshire. Then we had the result and there was a fair degree of debate to be had. And now an independent and a group of former Conservative councillors have demanded that Cheryl Gillan attends a public meeting in Great Missenden to explain her position on High Speed 2. You remember she said that if the government didn't listen, she would resign. And we heard some quite balanced view about exactly what happened, and we heard from her in the first hour about why she didn't. However, the campaign continues. Now, Bucks County Council is using some taxpayers' money to contribute to a fighting fund against High Speed 2, and other people are coming up with their own ideas. However strongly you said you felt against it to us, how strongly do you really feel? Would you put your, for example, hand in your pocket to fight the government?
Yes, I mean, the morning that we were awaiting the decision for HS2, whether it would get the go-ahead or not, and the prediction was, which was true, that it would get the go-ahead. We were inundated, weren't we, Simon, with people calling us and saying, this is preposterous. And we even said, you know, oh, do you live on the route then? And people said, no, I don't live anywhere near the route, but I still am adamantly against it. Doesn't matter whether I live on the route or not. I think it's a complete waste of money. I think they should invest the money that they're going to put into HS2, into our train services that we already have, and concentrate on those and improve those rather than building HS2. People were against it for environmental reasons and the impact they felt it would have on the countryside. But this morning, we'd like to know from you all those arguments that we had on the day, and the majority of you were vastly against HS2. Now it's come to the crunch, and now this is being launched, and £100,000 is needed in order to get this campaign up and running against the government. Will you be dipping your hand in your pocket to help out? Or actually, are we a nation where we say, oh no, I don't agree with it, but when it comes down to it, we don't really do anything about it? 08459 455 555.
Keep your thoughts on that coming through. 7 minutes past seven. So the campaigners against High Speed 2 will take legal action, they say, over the government's decision to approve the scheme. It could cost as much as £100,000. And local councils, as we mentioned, including Buckinghamshire, are going to contribute to a fighting fund. Well, Joe Rukin is from Stop HS2 and joins us live this morning. Morning, Joe. Thank you for joining us. Who actually is involved in this?
Well, there's 51M Group, which is a group of 18 local authorities, which aren't just local authorities on the line. It includes Coventry and Leicester, which aren't, you know, affected physically by HS2, but obviously will be detrimentally affected by their cities getting worse rail services and economic activity sucked away from them. There's various environmental groups, and there's over 70 action groups all, you know, opposing the project. And Justin Greening may have decided to go ahead, but the fight is a long way from over.
It's interesting you mentioned Coventry, because obviously slightly further north in Birmingham, the view is very, very different. When you look at the local news up there, yes, there are people who feel that they perhaps don't want it, but certainly there are many people, particularly local business, who support it. Why do you think in this area people who are against the plan are right?
Well, simply, there's no business case, there's no environmental case, there's no money to pay for it. We've got to where we are from strong lobbying from vested interests, and you can deliver more benefits to more people more quickly by investing in the existing infrastructure.
Now, you're a group of...
It's a disaster.
You're a group of volunteers. Where are you going to find the money to fund this? We're talking about that could cost around about £100,000.
Well, we've raised lots of money over the last 2 years. It's gone on various things. And it's all from grassroots community action, normally. Quiz nights, wine tasting, raffles, that sort of thing. And we've been very successful so far. Obviously, there's been a lot of individual donations as well. But there's been a lot of people who said, this is when the fight actually starts, and come knock on my door after the decision is made. Because, were pretty certain the government were going to be completely intransigent about this, and it would have to go to a legal challenge. And Justine Greening herself, when she was opposing the third runway at Heathrow, she said, if you know, it was deeply disturbing that ministers hadn't listened to the consultation, and if they won't listen to in Parliament, they'll have to listen in the courts. And although the spin is that the government cancelled the third runway at Heathrow, just before the general election, a judge ruled against it, and they just decided not to appeal. You know, it was totally incompatible with the objectives of the 2006 Climate Change Act.
And just lastly from you, because obviously there'll be many people interested in the timescale of all this, how quickly do you have to act? How quickly will this have to go through the courts process before the government's will is the one that's maintained?
Initial application will have to be made by April. But obviously there's chance of further legal challenges after that when the environmental impact analysis has come in. The other thing that I've been told to mention today, Dominic Grieve has an open meeting at 11 o'clock in Higher Denham on Saturday for any of your listeners who are available to go. But for more details about the judicial review and if you can help, please go to stophs2.org.
Many thanks for joining us live on the programme. And of course, at that meeting will be the MP for Beaconsfield and the Attorney General, as you heard there, live from Joe Rookin, who's from Stop HS2. £100,000 as the fighting fund. Some of it, of course, will be contributed from taxpayers' money from Bucks County Council. But what about you? You've got something you don't like. You want to fight against it. Would you put your hand in your financial pocket to fight the government? 81333, start your message with 3CR.
Joe said there that they're raising the money through quiz nights and charity fundraisers. But I tell you what, Simon, you've got to do an awful lot of quiz nights in order to get £100,000, haven't you? So on the day when the announcement came through, so many of you vehemently against HS2. Now it's come to the crux and they need your money, they need your support in order to raise this campaign. Will you put your hands in your pockets?